welcome back to my channel. This is Christine. If this is your first time visiting my channel, I'm a college kid. I love to do a lot of weird things. I love fashion, I love coding, I love exercising. There's just a lot of things I love to do. So yeah, welcome, and I hope you subscribe. So today I want to talk about Vanderbilt, the college I am currently attending, and the reason why I'm doing this is that I know it's that time of the year again. People are touring campuses, deciding which college they should go to. And I literally run into so many parents touring the campus every single day on my way to school. So yeah, I thought, why not make a video about this college I'm attending and just talk you guys through some of the pros and cons of attending and just, you know, some of my heartfelt advice. So without further ado, let's just get into the video. So in this video, I'm gonna break it into several parts that I think are important aspects of a college. So first of all, we have to talk about academics, right? Like majors, or what majors are the best at the school, and just in general, how's the teaching and all that stuff. And I'm also gonna be talking about dorm versus, you know, other housing options, because I think that's also really important for like college life quality. On that note, I'm gonna be talking about food a little bit as well. And I want to also touch on the people, how the fraternity is, what's the culture at the school. And obviously, internship, job seeking, all these prospects are also important stuff to touch. And lastly, I'm gonna be talking about just stress, what it actually feels to be at the school, whether it's overwhelming, because I definitely think mental health are very important to college kids. So yeah, these are the categories of video. So let's get into it. Let's get into it. Let's get into it. So first, let's talk academics. I know Vanderbilt is pretty highly ranked on US News and other, I guess, major college ranking systems. The year I got in, I remember it was 14, 15, right there with Cornell. So yeah, depends on your goal. I think really it's a pretty good like score in terms of ranking. But that being said, it definitely depends on what you want to study to decide whether you want to go here. For example, I think Vandy has this very strong life sciences and HOD. Like HOD means human organizational development. It's a major that's kind of unique to Mandy. So it's mostly for entrepreneur and HR stuff. So if you're into that, they have a really awesome program. And the life sciences, like neuroscience, biology, and also psychology, they're all like really popular majors here, and they have so many campus research labs available. At least on my first year when I was thinking about becoming a doctor, I definitely easily joined many labs to work with. And I think that's like just a lot of resources available for people who are pursuing that sort of degrees. So yeah, if you're a life science major or you're looking into more of a educational or entrepreneur or HR stuff, then Vanderbilt is definitely a school for you. Yeah, but in contrast, if you want to become like an engineer on the CS side, or even if you just see the very minute possibility of becoming one, I would really caution against coming to Vanderbilt, because to be very honest, I don't think our CS program is that strong, at least not for like general software engineer. I guess more of it is in the theoretical realm, and there's just not a lot of resources or really applicable classes that you can take to your industry. Most of it is still like basic intro courses, so yeah, like I definitely don't think it's as strong as say CMU or Stanford or even Berkeley in terms of the mechanical side of things. So yeah, but again, I know college is such a confusing time. You go into college as a freshman thinking you're gonna become a doctor. No, I'm not. I'm not talking about myself. And then 1 year later, you're just like, this is so boring. I want to change into a computer science and math double major. And that happens. you'll be surprised how often that happens. So yeah, I think one of the mistakes I made when choosing which college to attend was that I didn't really, I guess, lay out all of my possible future choices. For example, I was so adamant in becoming a doctor or like just being pre-med that I just didn't think about the possibility of me getting into the tech industry at all, like at all. So I just never thought I would do that. So Vandy, despite its kind of weak CS program, I thought it was a really good fit for me because, you know, like, why does it matter if it's weak? I'm never gonna get into it. But if you are someone who's volatile and loves to change as me, I definitely think you should caution against coming, just, you know, because your future or your interests could change so fast, especially when you're taking all these introductory level courses. You will be surprised how many things you are interested in. So yeah, summary, if you are very adamant and very confident about life sciences, education, or HR, entrepreneur, or just like psychology and stuff, I think Vandy is really great for that. But if you see even like a minute chance in becoming an engineer, I would really weigh like Vandy against other options you have. Okay, next I want to talk about the living condition, the dorm life, and off-campus life. So Vandy is kind of special in that it's really emphasizing the on-campus living experiences. So in contrast to some of the big state schools like UC San Diego, where pretty much you get to live off campus the first year because there's just so many students there, Vandy is actually kind of mandatory in requiring people to live on campus. For example, you know, I know most schools would require you to live on campus in dorms on their first year, but Vandy is actually doing that pretty much all 4 years. Did you know that you actually have to use a lottery-like system to get off campus? Whereas in many schools, that's actually the opposite. You lottery to get into on-campus housing. But Vandy just loves, loves, loves students to be on campus. And we have our very special residential college program where it's like a little Hogwarts, if you put it in a beautiful way. But obviously there are still some downsides to it because the residential colleges are really awesome. Like, they're like real Harry Potter stuff, but there are also a lot of really crappy dorm rooms. For example, my freshman year, everyone lived on commons, which is a really nice area to live in. But my second year, my sophomore year, I didn't get the lottery to get into one of the nice housings. So I lived in like a really crappy area without AC, and it was like a really small corner room I had to share with my roommate, and we pay like $1,300 a month, which is not worth it. Even my current apartment is like just a little bit above that, but look at all these area. So yeah, if you're someone who definitely has like a tendency to live off campus, I wouldn't recommend Vandy because it's just really hard. Pretty much you have to be a senior in order to get off campus. But obviously last year, because of COVID, they loosened the policy and I got to live off campus, even though I'm currently still on my third year. But yeah, next year they're pretty much not letting anyone live off campus because like all these juniors out there off campus and stuff. So yeah, but on the other side, if you are someone who values like a typical college experience where you can have so many like classmates down the hall and you can power party with them very conveniently, and you just want to have that like public study room atmosphere sort of, then I think Vandy is definitely the one to go, because frankly, unless you're going to like a very small liberal college, then Vandy would probably be the most close-knit living condition you'll ever see. And some people love it, some people hate it. I'm kind of neutral. I prefer to live off campus because I think it's cheaper, it's better return on my money. But yeah, if you want a more typical college experience, then Vandy should be good for you. Next, let's talk about food. I'll be honest, I'm not extremely picky about food. I'm pretty much good with whatever I'm fed with, as long as it's edible, it's somewhat nutritious. So yeah, Vandy to me has really good dining options, even though I think it's kind of overpriced. Every meal is like $9. Obviously, if you buy like the meal plan, which I believe have like 9 meals, or I don't remember what's the lowest, but the standard was 21 meals for freshmen, I believe. So you eat like 3 meals every day, which is kind of ridiculous because I don't think most people are that regular. It was so common that I couldn't use up all my meal swipes, that I leave like 5 or 6 meals at the end of the week, and then sometimes they just go to waste. And I just think it's kind of ridiculous how expensive the meal is. But obviously, if you're someone who's really into fitness and you want to eat regularly, then Vandy is definitely the place to go. We have smoothies, we have all kinds of like quinoa bowls, we have weird stuff, we have nutritious stuff, we have Asian food in one of my dining halls, which is awesome. And we have eggs, we have meat, we have vegetables, we have sweet potatoes, we have everything that you can think of, as long as you're willing to pay the price. So yeah, it's pretty good, and I would definitely say they are trying to be healthy and all that. But again, I might not be the best person to consult about food, because I honestly just don't have that much passion about it. And now I live off campus, I don't have to buy a meal plan, which is great, because I think cooking on your own can be much cheaper. But yeah, food, okay, but not great for me, but many people think it's great. Yeah. Next, let's talk about the people here. The students, the staff, the faculty, let's just talk about all of them. First, I definitely think many people, when they're asked about Vanderbilt, they think about fraternities and sororities here, which is definitely true. I would imagine the frats here to be like a much bigger influence than somewhere, say, on the West Coast, UCLA and stuff. But honestly, I don't know. But as someone who doesn't really join these stuff, I don't think my life, like my quality of life, is impacted in any negative way, because I know about like just as many people who don't join any of these frats and stuff, and they're doing just fine. And even if like you do join a frat, there are like still professional frat, pre-professional frats, and also social frats. The social frats are more, The social frats are those who party, who drink very hard, and like pretty much your stereotypical bros versus hoes and stuff. Yeah, but the professional ones can be actually really interesting and really helpful in developing your personal careers. They're like pre-medical stuff, they're like pre-business track, they're also just a lot of random fraternities, and I think you can definitely develop some really genuine friendship and derive a lot of value out of them. So yeah, I think it's cool that Vandy has a lot of fraternities. And as to like how friendly or like what's the culture like, I definitely think people here are really friendly. I definitely think part of it is the Southern hospitality thing. Coming from California, I wasn't really used to people calling me honey or babe, not babe, sorry, baby, when I'm getting my breakfast. I think it's just so heartwarming. I love it. It's really interesting to see different aspects, especially if you're not from this area. You'll find people like almost a little bit overwhelming in a good way, because they just greet you so heartily that you will just be like overwhelmed. You're like, oh. But yeah, I love the staff here. And as to the faculty, as I probably mentioned in the academics, especially if you're in one of the better like disciplines at Vandy, the professors are extremely nice. Even if you are like a CS student and math student like me, I think the professors are still really dedicated. I mean, there are like a few not so good ones that you can check on Rate My Professor, but I think that's the same across all schools. But I haven't really encountered any, you know, where TAs are teaching the classes and professors are just doing their research. That's virtually non-existent. The professors here in general like are very caring about your success, so I definitely love that and can't complain at all. So in terms of people, I would really give like a very high score for Vandy. Let's talk about post-college career developments, or like, I guess, internships, jobs, or going to grad school. So since I am from the CS field, many people I know that they land really good job offers right upon graduating college, and they don't have to go to grad school, or they don't choose to. They're going to Amazon, Google, Microsoft, all these big companies, and I think this is really good like job prospects for any like engineering student. And I don't know much about the social science stuff, but I do have friends who are doing social sciences and they go to top-notch grad schools like Harvard, like Columbia, and then just get so many offers. So I definitely think Vandy prepares you very well in terms of grad school. And in terms of jobs, again, as I said, I only know the CS part of the story, but many people from CS definitely do get really, really good jobs right after graduating. And some of them also choose to go to Stanford or Harvard to like pursue a higher degree. But yeah, it's awesome. I definitely think in terms of post-college, Vandy prepares you very well. Lastly, let's talk about stress. I definitely think stress is a very important factor in gauging which college you should go to, and sometimes I feel like people often overlook this subject, but I think mental health is very, 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 very important in terms of life quality in colleges. So yeah, overall, I think Vandy has a really good school life balance. People here are generally pretty chill, although you would find probably people on the more competitive end if you're going to one of the more popular majors here, like biology, like pre-med. Some of them can be kind of cutthroat, but overall, I definitely wouldn't say that's what everyone's like, especially if you're in the social sciences part or like the educational or HOD part of the school. The people there are generally really, really friendly, and they're not savage at all. I love these people, and I think engineering is somewhere in between. Some of them are cutthroat, some of them are chill, but again, that's just all my personal opinions that I just gained through my 3 years at Vandy. But yeah, don't quote my words on it. And yeah, as to stress levels and how much professors care about your personal well-being, I definitely think Vandy is doing a really great job at that. Personally, I have struggled with depression and anxiety when I was, I guess, mostly when I was in freshman year, and a lot of my professors really, like, they helped me out a lot. They talked to me, they actually cared about how I was doing, and then they pointed me to the right resources on campus, like the counseling center, and there's just like so many different options we can choose from, and that was just really, really helpful, and it felt really good to know that school actually cared. And this semester, even though we are living off, I am living off campus, and I definitely think I'm more detached from the entire campus activity. But I still feel that the school cares about us. We have reading days where we don't have assignments or papers due. Even though some people think it's useless, I definitely appreciate it, because a lot of my professors just decide not to give homework at all this week, and that's why I have time to film this video. Yeah, so that's great. And another point is, I definitely think Vandy students are really, really good hobbyists. We have Elliot Troy here, right? That says a lot. I definitely think we are all like really interesting people in general. We're not just like people who only know how to study and stuff. We have a lot of hobbies outside, and there are like all kinds of clubs here you can join. You'll be surprised at like what different things people are doing all the time. And yeah, it's just always so exciting. You can always find something to do. And especially not during COVID, campus life can be a lot of fun. So yeah, overall, really good balance between school and life. And I would really recommend anyone who's looking for a more chill college with a really good education quality, like, to come to Vandy, because I think it has truly been a pleasure to study here. Okay, that was all my talk points. To summarize, I definitely think if you are into life sciences, social sciences, education, HODs and stuff, Vandy from the academic side is really, really great. But if you're more on the engineering side, I would suggest you to look into other aspects of what I just said. And if you're a big fan of campus living, campus life, Vandy is definitely the school for you. But if you are big on like getting an apartment right into college, then Vandy might not be the one for you. And again, Vandy has a really like friendly student population, and we are usually really chill. We're not cutthroat. We are like really friendly people. The professors are caring. They do try their best to teach. And we have overall like a low stress level. So yeah, that was my entire presentation. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And yeah, just let me know if you have any question in the comment section. And I'll see you guys next time.